Hi, welcome. This is Krista at Krista's Art Gallery. Today, as I promised, we're going to go live. I'm going to try to paint something different. If you look closely, you'll recognize that this, if you have been watching along with me before with our sip and paints, this is something I never did. This is Point Udall in St. Croix, U.S. Virgin Islands. And today I'm going to be painting this. I'm going to do a combination with this, where I'll do more of a sunset. Once we finish with this, I would have the video for you, and you can also get the art kit to match. Again, this is Krista at Krista's Art Gallery. Thank you for joining in, my friends. So you'll be able to have the sketch. I would make sure that you have the print of it. You'd be able to then transfer it to the paper that you would have to transfer. Okay, here we go. So I have some colors here on my plate. So I have cambium yellow, I have cerulean blue, phthalo blue, we have some gray, white, burnt sienna, yellow ochre, and I have a darker cambium yellow deep. So I'm gonna start with the sky today. So I'm gonna take some white and mix it in with my blue. And I'm gonna start with the sky. I'm gonna be going straight across with the sky. So once you have the drawing in already, once it's already drawn for you, or you can draw it the day before you're ready to paint. You will have guidance with that. I'll make sure that you have the tracing paper if you have difficulty drawing easily, so that you can get a feel for drawing yourself. Okay, so I'm gonna have some cerulean. I want it a little darker, so I'm gonna add some of my phthalo blue to it. I think that's about the color I want. I just doing a simple sky for now. I like to paint the sides of my canvas and down and above, so when I'm finished, if I'm not able to frame it right away, at least all the sides and the top bottom would be covered in paint also and protect my canvas. So here we go. So I'm trying not to paint over now. If you haven't mastered cutting, which is what I call this, I can also have some tape for you. As I continue here, I want to wash the brush out a little. I want to start to add some yellows in there.
I think that immediately it's going to be done.
It's just the first coat of the paint I'm putting on. We have another coat. So I want to make sure it stays more yellow than it is right now. So what I'm trying to do here, I'm putting in the yellow for the sunset. It's a bit bright, we're gonna darken it up a little as I go along. I decided to do the background first, and then I'll sit after. I would go ahead and do I'm painting pretty quickly at this point. You don't have to paint so fast. You can also go ahead and stop the tape at any point. I'm trying to mix in here now. We're going to put another orange. So I have some orange here. If you got a kit, you would have the different colors in the kit with you. I want it a little, it's a little bright. So again, this is just your first coat. So I'm just filling in quickly, as quickly as I can. This is a flat brush that I'm painting with today. This is acrylic paint, so if you think that you made an error or you don't like how something looks, you could always go back over it. So that's not a problem. Okay, you can use your white, white out something if you don't like how it's looking as we do this. I'm trying to do this as simple as possible. I'm putting in the yellow part because, you know, when we mix our yellow, once we mix the yellows with the blue, you're going to get a greenish, you'll get green depending on the shade you do. So once I fill in here, you will start to see one thing with acrylic paints, they dry pretty quickly. Again, I'm going back to using yellow. The is the Cambian yellow. This is the horizon that I'm lining off here. Again, for this you could have some tape. Just taking a little water. Usually when I paint, I also have paper towel so I could dry off a little bit. If the brush is a little too wet, I usually use paper towel. You could do that also. I want it to be a little lighter. As the sun is going to come through right here. So, when it dries a bit, trying to avoid getting a green effect here. So when that dries a bit, I'll go back up with the blue and kind of fill in. Again, I'm still with a flat brush. I haven't changed the brushes as yet. I'm just twirling the brush a bit. I'm going to add some orange, fire orange in here. So we have choices here. So when you get the kits, you can have your direct color, the colors will be written on it, or if you have to mix, you will be given instructions of how to mix the colors as you go along. So it's up to you. You could mix your red and yellow and you'll get your orange, and you mix, depending on how much of which one you mix, you know, the color will either be brighter or darker. And it depends on which shade of yellow you mix also. Though I'm on Facebook Live today, because I'm painting, I can't really see who's watching. Because I'm trying to get the painting in while you look along. Space, because we have some blues showing out through here also. So I'll come back and get that in. So I just leave that there so that it could come back at a little bit. When I come back in there, I can do that. So again, you could paint along with me once you have the kits. You'll be able to sketch if this is one you might be interested in, because we have had so many people enjoying our sip and paint here at the studio. We know with the situation that we are with the COVID-19, it's not as easy for us to get in groups anymore like we would have prior to this situation with COVID. So in the, you know, in efforts to ensure that we remain as safe as we can and as healthy as we can, I'm presenting you with another option of doing your sip and paint. Wanted to do these for a while, but schedule didn't allow, so today I decided let's just do it. So I just washed my brush out. I'm gonna go back with the blues. Always have to remember that acrylic paint dries so quickly. So sometimes when you think you have time, or the paint is already drying and you know, I don't wanna let that go in too much to the yellow without the yellow being dry, because then I'm looking at a situation of a green. Cerulean blue and white again. A little cobalt blue with it. So I can get it a little darker. Yellow dry. Let's try some. I'm still painting with a flat brush. You could use a flat or a round brush, whichever one is more comfortable for you. Eventually do this blue a little darker, but I'm putting it in for now, hoping that the yellow is a little dry. I'm using the corner of the brush and around all these clouds a little bit, tip of the brush. So that's my first coat up there. I could go in and put in the horizon piece for... So I'm gonna use some yellow, orange, a little burn sienna. Because on some sides, there's a burn sienna here with the orange. Because over here is a little bit darker. And I'll go back up to the top, so... I'm mixing burnt sienna and orange with a little yellow. Now, if this is a little challenging for you, because we're trying to do now, this is where the water would be with the horizon, right here. If it goes off a little bit off of the line, of course, you could have the drafting tape That would also assist. Or you dress as acrylic, so you could just go over it and straighten it up. Usually when I paint in my quiet time, so this is something new for me. Having to paint and speak at the same time, I have to remember to do that as I go along. But I know some of my fans and people who have been painting with me have been asking, when are we going to do another sip and paint? So I'm trying to bring some of that joy that you usually have when you come here to you. So that's one coat. I'm gonna put this side over here. This side is even darker. Basically that we're doing here. So there's burnt sienna and orange combined with some yellow. To do is to start looking at the other parts where that had dry a bit so that I could go back in with it. So I'm going to be using a gray, right? So I'm going to use gray with a little white, and also, so I'm going to do this part of the painting now. And this is a little bit darker than I have it there, so I may need to darken this gray a bit. Because it's supposed to be a little later in the day. trying to get that brick effect, so I'm just cutting a little bit first to keep the shape. Probably better off with a bigger brush just to cut. So once I have that, then I can go in and do my filling in. Okay, so back to the smaller brush. Randomly putting in some pieces here. I'm trying to get that stone effect. So I'm trying to build up that effect there with the stones. Ever been to Point Yudal, you realize you have some beautiful stones here. So I'm just going in and out, different ones, different, just randomly putting in pieces. You draw it to make it look like stone if you like, you can just do the pieces of them. This will be dark, so you have the option of darkening the gray or washing it when you finish. It's a darker color too, but a wash over the gray. Places to be all year's night. You want to see the first sunrise? You go to Point Yudal. People from all over the world come here and go up there for all year's night. Going back in randomly so that we don't have the same shade. So I need to do some lighter grays too. But I know it's pretty dark in there, so some of them would almost be black. Again, hi to anyone looking along at the live painting. Appreciate you looking along. Side one time. I'm Most of the stones up there have a, I point you that they are mainly like gray and like a yellow ochre color. So the majority of them are like, that would be that color you would see. A little quick on this side here. Again, feel free to stop the video anytime you like. Take a pause. Finishing touches, if something is not to your liking, go back in and do that. Wipe that up before it dries. I'm gonna try to stay within this space. Light is coming along. You know, you use the brush, it's just random. I'm just making random bricks. Usually see four pillars up there. I point you that. What I've done is, because of the angle the photo was taken from, you'll see the other one, the other two on the inside of the back side of this. So you'll only see part of it. Washing out my brush a little. Don't seem need to change my water just yet.
darkened that and then I think it's a little too, a yellow ochre is a little too bright for what I want to do. Some paper, towel. So I have my yellow ochre and I'm gonna put a little black or even brown. So I'm trying to fill in some of the spaces before. And I get a brick effect. I don't think I want all the white to go away, but because of it being a sunset, I'll have to have this as dark as possible. I could also go in and wash this, as I said before, we could wash it with thinning out the black, probably the black very thin, and then wash it out. Just trying to fill in the parts that doesn't have color. So that's yellow ochre I'm painting with. I'm putting a little tinge of, just to add some flavor here where the sun is going to be hitting. I put a little tinge of burnt sienna with this. Coming right into the end here. So it's just different. The effect is to try to get the effect of the stones. Remember, this is still the first coat. Up, put some of the yellow ochre in between. I wanted to try something different today because when we are in the, this is something we never painted before. We didn't have opportunity to paint this one in the studio. I'll let that dry and then I'll come back. Oh, I didn't like how that came out. Take a look at it. I'm going to try to put some yellow in here also. I'm going to put some yellow ochre. Going as fast as I can. I started off painting, if I had to do this, I would have drawn every brick out. Because that's my, usually, for my details, I like to, but we know how long that's going to take us to. So. So we're just trying to put it in different places, so we don't just have one color. We put it in different places, we won't be stuck with just one color throughout. since I had a little bit of that color there, I made sure I added it over on the next side. The interesting part about this, because it's sunset, you'll have some orange coming in here also. So we need to wash over some of this with some orange. See, it starts to make a difference right here. By putting in the orange. Fill in. Continue to fill in the missing spots. I didn't rinse it off. I can see how that is blending in there. Alright, coming along. Same thing for this side, put a little orange over it. Okay, I think we're coming along. Remember, that's just the first coat that I put on there. These bricks are just random. Seems to be some pretty type of stones actually. It's pretty, it's much darker on this side. So I have to make sure that we have to make sure that we have the darker shades on this side. Alright, coming along. It's a good way to relax, and this doesn't have any set. You don't have to sit down and draw a lot. You don't have any, you know, in terms of the stones, you don't have to draw the stones a lot. You know, and you go ahead, you just take your time. Pause if you need to. Take a break, come back if you need to. So I'm straightening up this a little. Remember, if you are painting this and you wanted to change something a little, you can do that. Coming down to the end, I'm going to make it a little darker, also to the end. So I went back in here. Now, I'm not finished with my background, I'm not finished, but I'm gonna leave those for a little bit. I need to cut.
West entry door.
Thank you. get an effect of that sunset. Reflecting in here, changing the color a little bit, as dark as it may be. Alright. Coming along. So I would make the one that would be on the back side that you wouldn't see. I want to make this a little darker here so that it's very clear and distinct from the other one. So we're going to make it. So I'm just trying to cut it here. But I'm going to go in very dark. This is the other part. It's four parts there are. You should up there when you go up there, you would see four of these pillows. So I'm trying to do the other ones that are on the back side of these. Depending on where you take the photo from, you may or may not see these. Something and you didn't like how it looked, the line or so, you could just take it up before it dries quickly so that you could go ahead and straighten it with acrylic. You could do that. Acrylic allows you to do that. Unfortunately, some other media would not. But if you're painting with acrylic, you'll get lucky to be able to make your corrections as you go along or after you finish. So don't be frustrated if you're doing something you don't like how it looks. Right? You could go ahead and make subtle changes. I'm cleaning up this a bit. Again, you can also clean up a little bit with your brush and water if you like a little. I always have paper towel with me when I'm painting, so I could do that. Okay? And this is the other side, so I can get some orange, and I want the orange there a little darker.
West entry door.
$500 piece for the back. Got a pillow on the back side. So here we are. That's just the door in the studio. Whenever someone comes in or out, it will alert me that someone is in the studio. So if I'm painting, I can make adjustments as needed. So not something to worry about. Alright, so we are getting there, bit by bit. And it's dry. As soon as it dries, I'm gonna go in and do some cleaning up of it. Okay, let me put in some more and then I'll go back and play around with that sky and the clouds. So remember, I had put yellow, a little yellow with the orange, and some burnt sienna to fill in here. This is actually our water as the sun sets. Okay. So I'm putting it in water here too. As we look out. You get an awesome view from Point Tudal when you get a chance to visit us here on St. Croix. It's really nice, beautiful up here. Okay. So I gotta go now to a little green. We're gonna do some green here. I have some hookah's green. I'm trying to look at it. I'm gonna use a rounded brush at this point. So I have a smaller rounded brush. I'm gonna use it. The rounded one. I'm gonna use a little yellow ochre. I'm gonna use a little ochre right here in this area here. My brush is a little too wet. I'm gonna dry it out a bit. So this is our yellow ochre. I'm gonna do this one the same way random because I'm gonna put back some. I'll do the grass after, but here also have some bricks. There's an area here that also have some bricks, some stones. All right, so let's just put that in and done randomly. I don't know if I prefer this one or using the flat brush, but let us see. Yes, it looks like waves, huh? But that's not what I want though. So I go back to my flat brush. Because I'm trying to paint this and also
have you see it. So I'm not directly in front of to allow you to see what I'm doing. Alright, that's better for me. I'll make some of these darker. This one's going on is dark. Let's just fill in a little bit. Some of my green that I wanted to do. My yellow ochre. I don't want the green to be so white. So I have some yellow ochre again. I'm putting in here because I'm putting some grass in here. The interesting thing about it now, all here is green also, so right here is green. So I'm gonna use a bigger brush and get some green moving. Steel pan in the house. Some ochre green with some cambium yellow, some yellow ochre. You know, when you're painting and you start to see the whole canvas getting full, you can get excited about that, huh? That yellow is pretty bright.
yellow ochre. So the space you see me leave out there, that's a walkway, and that's stones also. So, here we are. Point you down, we're getting there. So I'm just mixing the green with yellow. I'm using two yellow, I'm using the cambium yellow, and I'm also using yellow ochre. So it, you know, could get some green in, so it's not a flat green. Kind of keeping it flat for now. Trying to paint all the way to the end of, to the edge of the canvas. I'm trying to do it a little lighter as it comes towards me, and darker for that part, but with the sunset everything seems to look pretty dark. So I'll go back in. They say we could wash stuff, so we could look forward to making sure that the grass is not going to look as green as it is, or it usually will. Some parts in, I think it's coming along. Usually when I paint, I like my stuff pretty clean, so I would go over this. You know, you have a chance to go over, you could go over your painting, you just get it. We have point you dot in. I gotta do the piece still in the center, the pole in the center. And that's going to be orange and burnt sienna. As we come right here, that's burnt sienna and orange, and then it's going to start to get darker. We have another bit of the burnt sienna and orange here. Put a little more burnt sienna on that as it goes up. First, the light seems to be happening right in the middle there, so I'll come back to do that. One thing we could be sure of with the acrylic paint, it will dry quickly. So need that to be a little darker. I use paper towel to dry out the brush. Some more black in here.
out a little bit again and just stick it up before it dries. Good. That's a better one there for me. And with this, if you're having a difficult time keeping it within the line, you could go back and clean it up after. You just get trying to get it in, get it in. Fill it in, you could come back and clean it up after. Again, you could pause at any time. So I would remind you, this is Krista from Krista's Art Gallery. I am doing this for you and for me to relax also. If you would like to paint something like this at home, I would have it ready for you in a kit. You could just put in your orders. Interesting how when you're doing dealing with the sunset, those nice bursts of reflections that you see as you go along, you know, you see it orange, you see it green, yellow, sorry, you see orange, you see yellow, you see as many colors. It depends on what time is happening too. As I've stood there in Frederickstown waiting for it, I've stood up here waiting for it, and don't take your eyes away. Alright, so it's coming in. So what I'm going to do now is put in the walkway. So I'm going to use gray to do that. There's a walkway there, when you get here. And I want to do that dark too, because again, putting in the walkway. I'm cutting with my this is stonework also. I'm using my flat brush. You can use a rounded brush, just don't twirl it too much. Okay, some of this is going to be pretty dark, so I don't have a choice here. Hit and miss, hit and miss, hit and miss. Okay, so since I did that part there, I'll do here, because this is also part of the walkway. This little piece here, try to do that. Leave a little part for the yellow stone. Okay, and then we come over here. I may as well do that because I have all the gray. When I saw bright at black, oh, that looked at black came and just took over everything. see what I'm doing. I'm going back in. To the bottom here. Darkening, adding some color in, darker color in. And some of the spaces. I want to go back in and add some yellow ochre, but I'm adding some black mixed with gray or black itself for this end here. I want it to be darker, and then I'll go back and play around with my clouds after. Just your feel of it. It looks like stones. That's the goal. You want to have it have that look like the stones up there. If you've never been to Point Soudal, so you're trying to get that effect of the stones there. I'm gonna go back and work on the clouds a little bit after. So randomly I'm going in and filling in the spaces here. I'm putting some in the walkway too. The thing with acrylic paint, you're painting with it and once it dries, just put your other colors in. You could also do blending if you like to blend a color in with another while the one is still wet. Next time, so if this is your first time, then you know you just take your time, and then the next time you make adjustments accordingly. In some way, there's also path and a stonework. This is a stonework door on the wall part, this wall. The wall part here. Okay. All right, coming along. Now I just have a little water on my brush and I'm blending in some of these colors now for the stone. It's kind of just, it's almost like glazing, you know. So I'm just taking, I put a little water on the brush and I'm kind of just filling in. And where I need it to be darker, I could glaze the edge too. straighten this a little. To see me paint all the time. So here we go. I don't want too much of that there, but I want to make sure I have not too much white popping through because of the time of day. Are we good?
Yeah, we're good, we're good.
All right, I thank you for looking along. I'm gonna go back to the sky in a bit. Let me just clean this up. So there's a clear distinction between this one. One on the back side, right? Good. There too. Push it a little.
West entry door.
I want to turn this a little. Sometimes even if you want to cut, you need to spin the canvas, you can. So if we needed to turn this a little bit like this, you could turn it in that direction as you try to cut here, you know, organize here. Sometimes it's easier to work with it if it's turned this way. You need to get your line to be a little straight here. Put a little bit of water on the brush. And I'm just cleaning it up. Cleaning it up. You see the difference when I turn it back around too. You could do this. Anytime you're painting. I have the distinction between this and the one behind of it. So. Thank you if you're still here looking along with me. I want to make sure that I have pointed out right for you. First time I'm painting this one. And those of you who know, us at Crystal's Art Gallery, we have painted a variety of things. But I like it. Celebrating the art and culture here. This is one. And if you visit St. Croix, need to go and see. Point you that. Alright, so I'm gonna make sure I have here dark and nice. And I wanna do the same thing to the next side. So I flipped it around, sorry. Hopefully you can do the same at that point too. You may find it easier to straighten the line if it's overturned in this direction. For me, it's a little easier to cut. And you could also add a little water to help you with that. blend this in a bit, so I don't, because I don't want to lose other colors either. So I wet the brush a little and I blend it in the black. Coming along. If you'd like, you could thin out the black and glaze this. It's very thin. A little bit of black with water, with a lot of water. You can see how it looks here. A little bit of black with a lot of water, and then you could glaze it to help darken what you have. That with any color, sorry. That's why you have to have on your apron. It's good to paint with your apron on so you don't even lose your beautiful clothing. You know? So if you want to do a sip and paint party at your home, with this one, if you like this one, it's something you could consider to do that. Alright, so point you down is almost there. I have to go back and work on my stripe. It's part of the wall, so I just mix it in gray. Here is part of the wall, so I'm just filling that in. That's like a part of the wall you would actually sit on the ledge. If you go up there, you'll be sitting here. You have your grass, you have your little walkway. It would be a little darker, that's like the little lip, the little edge of the wall. So I'm going to just make that black. Simple as I can. and speeding it up.
All right. So this one on the other side is pretty dark here. There's some brown with some black in. I put a little black in the orange over here and some brown with it. Over here it's a little darker. I think I'm liking how it's looking and it's coming along. Trying, you right here with us. We are painting. I like the effect I'm getting there. I'm gonna switch my water soon. Yellow is a little lighter. Coming to our sunburst. This is where now I'm gonna put that sunburst. This as simple for you as I can. Okay, so I'm gonna do some yellow now and white, then I'll put some orange in here. I'm now using a round brush. This orange is looking here, so I'm not going to put much more of it. I don't think
white. A little too much white. So that's a yellow there. Try some purplish color somewhere. Second coat we put in on the blouse. We had one before. All right, so you want to put a little darker of some of the blue. Make sure my brush is clean, so I don't think so. On a little red, I'll get some purple color. Put a little purple in there. So I'm mixing right now a little red with blue. Get a little purple. So you have directions on the video where you could hear and see. And you would also have in writing for this kit, I would also have the directions in writing to make sure you could follow along. Okay? I'm getting a purple here. I'm going to try to put some purple in here and then come back. See, and I'm gonna get my purple in before, so we put in some purple clouds in here. And then I'll put some whites. Some purples and some of them more pronounced than others. And add some additional color in the clouds. Once one color dry, it's not too bad to put another color over it. So once the yellow is dry or the orange is dry, you could actually add the other colors. Again, if you'd like to do this one, it may seem challenging to you, you know. Once you start painting, you kind of get into your own style too, and you'd adjust accordingly. You can find your own style. I firmly believe that each artist paint their own thing, you know? So, sometimes no matter who we learn from or who's our favorite artist or who might be our mentor in art, once you really start painting, I find you have you may have some of what they do, but you tend to. So don't be frustrated, just go ahead and paint. Because you may say, oh, I don't look like yours. I don't think it, you know, you would get it as close to, the goal is to get it as close as you can. But I know, just go ahead. I'd probably keep putting clouds if you give me a chance. I have no fancy way of doing these. I just putting them in. They could probably take another coat or something. Just blending and buffing. So we should be wrapping up. Over here I have a lot of purples, so I need some more blue to make this purple happen. I didn't go with enough blue over there to make the purple happen, so. Come in! You may come in! Please excuse me.